Welcome back everybody to Fans. And we're on Cobra. I just need to pull out before these do. These catch up. And we're gonna carry on from where we left off basically. So we've got this I don't know if it's half full. It's probably about 3/4, in fact we can have a look. Yeah, 65% full. And basically, in the last episode, we cleared out the sheds. I think we did 2 or 3 loads of this, which is a lot. And we were doing field 3. So we just need to go and tip the rest of this. Hopefully do the whole field. I don't think we will, though. And then we need to do a little bit of seeding, maybe. I'm not sure. And then probably... I don't know what we'll do. Maybe a bit of slurring, maybe mixed in. I'm not sure. But I do apologise for missing Saturday's live stream and Saturday's video. I was extremely busy, and I had intentions of making one, and then by the time I looked at the pot and I was like, no, where's the time gone? So I didn't have time to do it, and I woke up late and had to go out. So I am really, really sorry about that, and I thought I'd better make this one, because it's actually Saturday night now, and it's pretty late. But I thought I don't want to miss Sundays, because I'm really busy Sunday as well, so I thought I'd get one made. So I think what we'll do is just get on with this. As I said last time, we don't want to waste any, so we need to keep the speed going up, and put this on so we know how much we've got. We're running out of fuel, but I want to see what the tractor does when we do run out of fuel, so that's the reason that I'm leaving that. Making good progress. Now the field's not perfect as you can see, but it's going to go a lot better with this. Well, I am hoping that. So, also that field there, I haven't forgotten about it. Still need to do it. It's just we'll probably do that when Nick joins, because it's quite a big field to do. Or we might do it on our own. I haven't decided yet. Just when Nick's available. And I'm very busy next week as well. But then obviously I finish, I think it's on the 18th of December, so there'll be videos through Christmas, and I don't know what I'm going to do, but I think there'll be, I don't think anyone will watch it because they'll be busy with their families and everything, but there'll probably be a video on Christmas Day. Not that I'll make it on Christmas Day, but it'll be uploaded then, so yeah. I'm nearly decided. In fact, we'll finish this field. I'm pretty happy with that. Didn't think we'd have enough to finish. Yeah, basically, I've decided that I'm going to get a PS4 controller, I think. I think it should work. I've had a look on quite a few websites and stuff like that, and most of them said that it works, so you just have to trick your computer into thinking it's an Xbox 360. But I don't really want an Xbox 360 controller, so if anyone does know anything about that, then just let me know. It's just I don't like the feel of the 360 or the One. I like the PS4. I'll just clear some bits up with this extra that we've got. Okay, wasting it. A few bits down here that we can get. Get little bits. I know you wouldn't keep stopping and starting in real life, but we are in farm sim. There's the last little bit. And we are done when we are empty. So I know that you need at least 2.5 trailer phones to do a field that size, which is a lot of manure, quite a lot of time as well. I'll take this back. Someone actually told me, I did a mod review on Friday, and that might be coming into the game actually. It's a real nice mod, in fact. I'll show anyone that's missed it, you should probably check that video out, because it's a real nice mod. And I think I'm probably going to put it in this game save. It's this one here. We do have enough to buy it, but I'm not sure what tractor we want to sell. I do feel like we're wasting money on that Deutz fire. We don't really use the Unimog much anymore, but I don't really want to sell that. This we will need actually, because we're going to be doing the pigs. The truck, we don't even use that because we've got, in fact, we don't have any low loaders anymore, do we? Could actually sell the truck, I'm not sure. Do you have any like low loader trailers type things? Don't think we do we? I think it could be beneficial to sell that, to be honest, as we don't need it. So I wasn't going to get it, but I'll show everyone. And somebody told me about the IC control. It affects the, when you have the HUD off, which is this, that's HUD off, HUD on, that affects your, like your IC control. So if I'm in cab, probably won't work. Look, it's not working. If I turn this on, it works. Now I should have spotted this earlier, but I didn't because I'm an idiot. So yeah. Thanks for letting me know on that one. I just dropped my trailer for some reason. We'll take this back, and it's only just starting to get dirty, to be honest. Tractor needs a wash. Something's on the road, I'm trying to remember. I also got an email off Amazon, just like an advertising email, and it came up with the Satex steering wheel, and it was, I can't remember exactly, but it was along the lines of £450 British, and I was like, that must be in euros or something, or dollars, and I looked and it was in pounds, and I don't know why it's so expensive, because I'm sure it was only about 200 or something like that, some sort of, wasn't that much anyway, it was a reasonable amount. Well, I don't know if it was that reasonable, to be honest. I think it was about 220. And it's gone up to 450. Now, I haven't really researched or looked. In fact, no, we'll keep this out here. I haven't really looked into it that much. But I just thought, if anyone, I know Danny's got it, so if you like to let me know, Danny, where you got it from, and if you don't mind telling me how much you paid for it. Because I was going to get that, but at that price, and you know, it's not going to be good for any games like, I don't know, GTA, then what's really the point? This tractor, I'm liking it dirty, to be honest, but I know other people won't. In fact, I'm just going to leave it there, and we'll take a look at this new one. So I've got the JCB. This John Deere we're not even using, but it's not doing any harm. We've got this guy. Now I'm not going to do a massive like mod review like I did the other day, but basically You know, you've got IC controls, you know, that opens up, back door, that opens. When you reverse, the screen comes on. It's not live, but it's there. And then you've got these weights that come on the back just by hitting 9, and you can go up to 1800 kilograms. So it's quite a nice tractor, actually. Props to Nick for actually telling me about it. So thanks, Nick. Leave that on there. There we go. Just to pull the 3-point hitch up. Right, I'm going for it. Didn't have a fast top speed. I think it's like 8 miles an hour slower than the other one. But I don't really mind too much. But we might get rid of the other great spy, to be honest. The one that's actually in the field at the moment. Don't know how friendly it is with course play or anything like that, so we'll have to do that as well. Speed up. Seems to be pretty true. It's down there. Everything seems to be nice. And the seat balances. It actually balances outside the cab. You can see it balancing there. That's a nice little feature. And there's also a nice block off the road. It's number, what doing here, just hitting random buttons. Let's pull the hood up. That's it. Control and Y. Oh, come on. So left control and Y on the keyboard. You gotta do it quite quick. So I think we'll have the number plate as Ollie. This is going to take all day. There we go. What should we have this as? P? T. And then Y. That should do. And then what's a good number? Six. Don't know why I chose six, but probably would have been better with 2 hours. But yeah, you get the idea of it. In fact, is that actually, is that an O or a P? That would be, correct me if I'm wrong, Denmark? An O, I have no idea. Just a random guess, to be honest. If you can give it a go. You can actually park it next to this one. I think it's modelled on this one. Or, you know, resembles slightly. But you can see the difference. Quite a nice difference, actually. So, yeah. Drop this, and oh, it wasn't in this plan. I'm sure it's got off. We'll give it a go, see what it's like. I think we've got enough seed in this, I'm not sure. Yeah, we should have. In fact, what I'm actually thinking of doing, because this is such a heavily used field, it's like a cut through. Now, I don't think anyone's done this before, but if you want to get through, you have to drive through the crops, which isn't my style, to be honest. Well, I don't mind off camera, but not really on. So, what I'm thinking of just trying, I can always plow it back in, but just putting grass in here and just running up to the top with it. So let's give it a go. It's not going to look brilliant straight away, obviously. That's because the grass is going to grow. So that doesn't look brilliant now, but it's going to be a definite path once it grows. So hopefully people agree and think that's a good idea. Hopefully. I know somebody will go, oh, that's crap, or something like that. Plus it gives more room for the combine to turn around, because the combine's a bit touchy. I don't know if it's going to plant this in there or not. I don't think it will, because it's grass. It's, I think it comes up as more permanent. I'm not sure. If I put a grass blade down this side, then it just cut the field in half, so I'm not going to do that. Well, not in half, but might drastically reduce the size of the field. And actually, I don't have any traction mods. It seems to be handle this pretty well. Yeah, it's not planting in it, so that's good. I think in real life you need to take a turn that short with this thing. But we'll learn it. I should probably do a head run. That's what I'm going to do. Now I've just done what I didn't want to do, but if you actually round the corners off in a field, or most of the time it's where you round it off and just do a smooth bend, try and show you when I get to this end. But instead of like just doing a sharp turn like I've done here, you go like this, and that's not really a good example because I went right to the edge, but you do a smooth corner, then the combine doesn't actually stop, it just goes round the corner. So that's pretty helpful if you want to speed up your combine. Having a bit of a headwind on should help too. It's not missing it. I probably need to put slurry on this. Still at 200,000, it's good for more salvage. We have more to go here. I know we do on the server, I think there's a lot to do on the server. If people are looking to join the server, then and by all means join, and I'll be recording on it soon. Wednesday's video, which will be, well, I'll say it will be Wednesday, but I'll probably record it on Tuesday or Monday night. So I'm busy this week, I need to revise, you know. So yeah, I'm nearly done here. It's taking me longer than I thought. I'm really messing around all the time. I need to patch with it. The guy at Dylan saw it. Should have been fertilised, but the game allows it and this drill allows it, so I'm not that worried about that. Stop one from the soul springs. I'll probably do that in the live stream. So if you are looking to join, I can't say for certain, but pretty sure Sunday night, which is tonight, if you're watching this, I'll probably be doing a live stream in about 7:30, maybe 8 o'clock. It's only going to be a short one, like 2 hours. So yeah, get this cleaned up and put back into its shed. Get it nice and dry out of the elements. Obviously it doesn't flood in farms in, but on a lot of farms near me, and especially a lot of towns and villages, been flooding a lot. A few flooded tonight actually. But never floods where I live, because I live on a big hill. But everywhere I go, it's always on a hill. Which is good when it's flooding, but bad when you want to go out on your bike. yeah, we'll get this. In fact, we'll fill it up. I know you shouldn't keep seeding them, I always say this, but just handy when we next need it. Plus, if we don't have any money next time, then we've always got it. Pretty easy to reverse stuff as well, although the wheels do turn too much. I addressed that in the mod review, but yeah, overall it's a nice mod, I think. Now I don't need it at the moment, so I'm going to put it in there. I'll put it to the side here. So let's just jump. I haven't used the JCB in a while. I'm not going to use it now though, I'm just going to put it in the shed. This John Deere might be going. I don't really have a use on the farm. That needs to be sold. In fact, I'll sell that off the camera. Let me just get it out of the field. We might as well use this mucky tractor. I'm not sure if there's any slurry. I think there might be some left, to be honest. This thing's getting dirty as well. Which is good. But I like the slurry equipment to be dirty. It gets very, very dirty in real life. And I've got quite a bit in this actually. Whoa. Turn it off, Jesus. Because I turned the hood on. Off, sorry. That is not good. Wasted a little bit there. But not to worry. Right, so we have a full tank, which is good. I think there's probably some more in there. I'm not to worry about that, but I'll hopefully get this little field done, field 4 in 1, maybe 2 runs, I'm not sure. Probably more like 2. We'll get the beacons on and get up there. That's a nice little screenshot. I always say this, but I like taking pictures more than anything else. And the famous pop-up is here. It always comes up in a video. So much so it's got a name. The screen will have froze for a second, by the way. Sorry about that, but I can't avoid it. Well, I can't if I found out what the problem was, but it does me in. Now, I know this doesn't throw very far. Yep. I don't want to miss much because I can't really waste it going backwards and forwards. Definitely get a better yield out of everything if it's fertilised, so I'm happy about that. And it's free, we're not having to pay for I said fertiliser, I meant slurry. Or manure or whatever you call it, but it's free, so we're not having to pay for fertilisers, which are pretty expensive to be honest. Especially in farm sim. I don't know about in real life, because I don't stuff like that. I don't live on a farm. And that's probably answered somebody's question. Well, if I'm a farmer, hit that when it does that. I miss a little bit. I don't want to overlap either. So 19. I don't think I'm gonna have enough. I feel it running out anytime, so anytime now. Oh, it's quite regular. Now watch it run out on this last little bit. The scary thing is I'm not even looking at the how much we've got. What a waste of me. Go. Oh. How unlucky is that? Jeez. Well, I might patch that up in the stream, but I think we're going to leave it there for now. Hopefully we'll see how this grass grows. Put a little bit of fertiliser on it, so it should be smelling and growing brilliantly. So yeah, thanks for watching everybody. I hope you all enjoyed this episode. We've done slurry and we've done manure, so I think that's quite a popular job in farm sim, as well as silage, but we didn't do that today. So yeah, thanks for watching everybody. I hope you all enjoyed, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye for now.